Hi, everyone. I have an honor to start this conference. I'm going to talk about Kapada and quality gates. So a couple words about myself. I'm in Salesforce for 10 years and I'm certified Salesforce specialist and certified Kapada specialist. At the moment, I'm doing release management in customer times. And I would like to tell you a story. Let's imagine that we are in a company which is called Far, Far Away Kingdom. In this company, there are powerful sorcerers, developers. One of them is called me, another one is called Lee. And what is coincidence, they live in their remote castles, in locations, they do their magic in their locations. And the president of the company has got a great trust of them. So he decided to create new functionality in his company software. New permission set. And this great permission set is going to be called transfer user. But something went wrong in any user story, something is going wrong. And developers received only half of the technical requirements. And they are going to create their own functionality in their own sandboxes. And they are going to be conflicting. It just a user story, never happened in real life. So this is how Kapada pipeline looks like. And we can see here that one of the developers is living in the dev one sandbox, another one is living in dev two. And the first one is not going to use Kapada quality gates, another one is going to use Kapada quality gates, and then we are going to see how we are going to resolve potential conflict, which was originated by probably some junior business analyst. So according to these requirements, me is going to develop permission set with the functionality of transfer leads, and Lee is going to create another permission set with the same API name with the functionality transfer cases. Again, it's never happened in real life. Our imaginary developer, me, or he is always in hurry, has got no time. And what he is going to do, he is going to do basic development step with Kapada. He is going to develop new permission set in his sandbox. He's going to link his code to the user story in Kapada. He's going to deploy his results to another environment. And then everything else will be taken care of by Kapada. So here we're going to see a small video. If you never seen Kapada in your life, don't worry about that. We are going to see it right now in action. So we have a development cycle. First of all, we are going to develop new functionality. And this functionality is going to be real simple. We are not going to use any code. We're going to use point and clicks. So I'm going to edit. And select sales, transfer leads checkbox, boom, done. So that is what all about our development. Now we have our development done, our sandbox, dev one. We can see it on the top on the screen. And now we are going to Kapada as a native Salesforce application. So user stories looks like any Salesforce object, and we can see that in this diagram, we are going to deploy from the one to UET sandboxes. So now we are going to commit our changes. We have transfer user permission set in our list. So let's check it. With the permission set, we are going to use another functionality of Kapada, which is called full profiles or full permission sets. So we are going to select only the permission set. We are not going to deploy any other metadata because everything is going to be contained in our permission set. Commit. Now our code is linked to our user story. And a few seconds later, we can check in our user story 00002, and we can go to the table of metadata, which is linked to this user story. You can check that, yes, transfer user is there. And now we are going to delivering part, and delivering is a deploy. So we are going just to click on promote and deploy checkbox, save. And that's it. Now deployment started. It's really quick and easy. Developer can always check the status of delivering of deployment in the user story promotion related list. So we can see the one to UAT. We have a promotion record here. And Kapada behind the scene created the deployment record. And that's it. So everything else is done automatically. As me, I can check the status of my deployment to UAT, reading Git promotion data, and boom, done. When we deploy something, we can do a smoke test, and with Kapada it's really easy. So right from this screen, I can go to UAT. We can see this org UAT. So it's org credential to UAT environment. If I click on org, open org, then and it's boom, we are in UAT sandbox. Really easy. And now we can check our permission set is deployed correctly. So actually in 5-6 minutes, so what we have done, we have developed new functionality, we have linked functionality to user story, and they deployed it to another environment. Now we're going to check it is in our UAT sandbox. Yes, we have transfer user permission set and everything is in place. Now our developer me has done his job, but we also have another developer. He's going to do his part of the job, and his name is Lee, and he is a bit more experienced than me. So what he is going to do, in addition to what has been done by me, he's going to check user story commits, he's going to open pull request, and he is going to check user story custom metadata in other user stories. Part of his development is going to be exactly the same, with the one difference that he is going to check not transfer lead, but transfer cases. So the same API name. It's another sandbox. Okay. So the pull request is really useful thing, not only for developers, pure developers, but also for consultants who is not code intensive, but they do a lot of functional point and click changes. We still are in process of linking our code to user story. Okay. But what we are going to do next, the first step after we committed our changes, after we linked what we have done in our development, is to check actual commits in the Git. And my advice, always check. We are going to another related list, which is called user story commits. And user story commits, it's a junction object in the Salesforce, where we can link our metadata, which is recorded in Kapada in Salesforce. So we can see this record here. Yes, it was transfer user in this commit. And immediately we can see what actually has been committed in our Git repository. Kapada can use different repositories like GitHub, GitLab, and Bitbucket. In this case, I am going to use Bitbucket. And here we can see that, yes, it was a transfer any case user permission with the permission to create and edit case objects. The second step is open pull request. What we have now, we have created our feature branch, which is linked to our user story. And we are going to deploy our metadata to the next environment. We are taking the feature branch and we merge it to promotion branch, and promotion branch is originated from the org branch of the next environment. So we're going to check if there are going to be any problems with that. So for that, we are going to click on open pull request button. Capada is resolving a lot of Git conflicts behind the scene, so you cannot even see it. But sometimes it's better to check. Now you can see there's a feature branch against the UET branch, and Lee is creating pull request. And immediately we can check it, and we can see that we have potential conflict. And now we can see that on the next environment, there are already functionality, the same API name, but different functionality. That's transfer lead against transfer case. And Git shows us this difference, and we can observe this conflict. So let's assume there is no conflict, and it was not deployed yet, but we have a more advanced feature in Capada. We can check potential conflicts against other user stories. So if in other user stories there were the same API name is committed but not deployed yet, even in this case we can see it. So for that we are going to use another related list, which is called user story metadata. And in Capada you can see this yellow triangle. If I click on the name, then we can see in which user story and in which environment we have potential conflict. In this user story, 00002, in this environment, we have potential conflict. So how are we going to check our potential conflict? We are going to click on pull request. In this time, our pull request is going to check our metadata not against another org, but against another user story. And here we can see the same conflict. But that was possible because we have only two user stories in at the moment. If there were some more user stories with the same API name, there would be more user stories to observe, but in this case, simple one. And now we have two pull requests with the two conflicts indicated. How are we going to fix this problem? The first thing is to identify that we have some potential conflict. I can apply to my tech lead and ask him what we are going to do. And the tech lead can check technical specification, find out that there are some inconsistency. He can also discuss it with the architect, and they can come out with a solution to fix this problem. To fix this problem, we are going to develop two functionalities, transfer any case and transfer any lead. So they developed this advice for Lee, and Lee is going to fix this problem. So he is coming back to the org and doing the same stuff in his sandbox, but this time he is going to do it right because now he knows how to do it properly. Transfer cases is already checked, and we are going to our sales part, and we are going to click on transfer leads checkbox. Done. Fantastic. Nice and easy. So we transfer leads and transfer case functionality. You also need permission to create and edit lead object and case object. Is always double check. So we are going to commit changes and check commits. So what we are doing right now, we fix the problem, and in the same user story, we are going to commit the same metadata to override our previous commit. And now we can see it in our user story that we have two commits, and the second one is with the correct functionality. So we updated our feature branch. And if we check our commit, now everything is in place. So we can see that there is transfer any case and transfer any lead. And in green, we can see that what was updated in our feature branch. Fantastic. So after committing his fixes, we can do our pull request. There's still going to be the conflict. But right now our commit is enriched with another functionality. So now we know this is correct. And this conflict is going to be resolved by Capada itself. It's not our business by this time. And here's a happy end of our user story. So Lee spent some extra 15 minutes, but he has done some preliminary checks and he made sure that his changes are not conflicting with changes of his colleagues. And he, now he's more sure about the quality of his development and delivering. Me would be a little bit surprised later on that his work has been overwritten, but he will learn how to use Git and Capada quality tools.
Max, thank you very much for your presentation. It was very interesting to hear about this new role that we now start seeing in the Salesforce implementation project.